dogs barking. There's a dog park right outside of my building and I get to face it all day while I work. It's the best thing ever. But anyways, if you hear little doggies barking, that's why. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, it is a bonus video. And I totally owed you guys this video from the week that I was moving and I didn't get a video up that week, and then I was supposed to do a bonus video the following week. Anyway, I don't know why I'm explaining this to you guys, but I decided to drop in and surprise you guys with a bonus video. For today's video, I'm going to be doing one of the many videos in the January theme, and it is going to be six healthy habits for successful people. Six habits you should do if you just want to be, you know, more productive and happy and organized. If you guys aren't following me already, I'll pop my Twitter and my Instagram right here on the screen. Definitely come check that out. And other than that, if you guys want to know the six healthy habits to change your life, then just keep watching. Okay, so the first habit is getting up earlier, which is so, I know, oversaid, overdone, but this tip will change your life. Even if you have work early and you're forced to get up, try and get up even a bit earlier than that so you can get more done within your day. It is ridiculous the things that we can get done when we know that there's something else we have to do. AKA, if you know you have school, if you know you have work, if you know you have all these other things, if you get up and you get like 1 to 2 things done before you even go to school or work or whatever it is you do, that sets the tone for the rest of your day to be so much more productive and you'll be in a way better mood. So set your alarm a little bit earlier. But when your body gets into the routine of waking up early, it just becomes an easier thing to do. If you struggle with getting up in the morning, I have a few tips for you guys, because definitely in the winter months, I find I struggle with it more because it's so dark when I'm trying to get up. A few tips that I've learned is, one, to put my phone on the other side of the room and on full blast, and to not allow snooze on my alarm. Actually gives you the option to turn snooze off. And if I know that I can't hit snooze because there is no snooze, I'll be more forced to get up because there's no other alarm that's going to wake me up. Prepare for your morning in advance. So the night before, set out what you're gonna wear, set out your workout clothes if you plan on working out in the morning, make your lunch, kind of get your, like, put your mug out by your coffee machine, just have everything. I don't know if that's just like a super nerdy thing that I like to do, but when I have everything planned and ready to go by the time I go to bed, it almost makes me excited to wake up in the morning because I've already started off so organized. Having a morning routine, it just kind of gives me something to look forward to in the morning. You know, I have my, like, the way I go about doing things, making my coffee, making a smoothie, but it makes me so excited to get up in the morning, and it's just super beneficial. So I highly recommend doing that. The second habit that will change your life is to prep your meals. This will change your life even if you're not doing it for the sake of getting healthier. If you want to save money, if you want to stop eating so much junk, if you want to just feel better, and not only that, make eating crappier foods or like going out for food more of like a treat, definitely start meal prepping your foods. A, gonna let you know what's actually going into your body. B, it's gonna give you more control, and also it's going to make it so that you're not so lazy and then you know order out food or just make something really crappy and fast. Every time I go to do groceries, I'll write out what I'm gonna meal prep, and I do meal preps on Sundays and Thursdays. I map out what meals and what snacks I'm gonna have, and it makes my grocery list nice and easy. That way I'm not overspending or overbuying. I can budget what I'm trying to go for. It keeps me eating so healthy. This is like, once I started doing this, this is when I saw the most change in my body, because I've been pretty relatively consistent with working out, I would say at least in 2016, and I didn't actually start seeing changes to my body until I started meal prepping and circuit training. Honestly guys, meal prep, it will change your life. The third habit I have to change your life is to start reading more, and I know that's very generic. Reading actually makes such a difference on the way we are, the way we speak. It doesn't even have to be nonfiction. You can read whatever floats your boat, but I find just forcing myself to do 2 chapters every other day, it keeps it so that I'm not constantly forcing myself to read every single day and getting bored with it. Right now I'm reading Red Queen, and even though it's like a teen fiction, just going through the storyline in your head, if you're reading nonfictions like You Are a Badass or The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck, books like that, reading 2 chapters every other day is going to expand your knowledge, it's going to expand your vocabulary, it's gonna get your mind out of the gutter all the time and out of just like what's in front of us and what's going on in our lives all the time, and it also constantly keeps your brain working. It's kind of like an exercise for your brain. And if you don't like to read physical books and you struggle concentrating, hi, I am the exact same way, and what I recommend is honestly get audiobooks, because even when I know it's a day that I want to get 2 chapters in, but I'm not in the mood to sit down and open a physical book, pop my headphones in or just play it out loud while I'm cleaning or doing dishes or making my meal preps, and it gets my 2 chapters out of the way, and I don't know, it's such a refreshing and just good thing to do. It's just a really good habit to do. The fourth habit that is going to change your life is budgeting your weeks or your months. This is so easy to do. You just map out how much money you have incoming. And then what are your necessities, AKA like rent, bills, your insurance, anything like that. So map that out. And then whatever you have left, budget that for the rest of the month or for the week. So if you give yourself like $100 of spending money every single week, that can include your groceries. If you have a little bit of extra money, you could go to a movie. If you can budget in something that you're trying to save up for, whether it be like a nice camera or a new car, when you start realizing where all of your money is being spent, it's crazy. It blew me away. The amount of money that I spent last year on food disgusted me to my core. The amount of money I spent on Starbucks disgusted me to my core. So giving myself a budget and then mapping it out weekly and monthly. And then also it kind of makes it a little fun because if I save a little bit more than I was expecting, I can spend it on like a candle or something I just really want to do that week or something that's like a little bit of a treat for myself. A huge tip that I recommend with doing this is I do all of my budgeting in my planner. So I'll do it on my monthly spreadsheet, which I actually learned my sister was showing me that she does that. So now I'm in the habit of doing it. And then if I know that there's any expenses coming like trips and things, I'll budget out a chunk of money for those and put it in the calendar. And then by the end of the month, writing down how much I should still have in my account for savings. Writing down those totals and doing it on a monthly spreadsheet makes it a visual thing for you. Life changing. The fifth habit to pick up that will actually change your life, and it's such a simple one again, is just walking more. Go for more walks, whether it be around your neighborhood, your city, if you're traveling. First of all, just getting the fresh air is so good for us that we don't even realize it. Like, we stay inside so much that we forget to get fresh air. Even if you don't have a dog, throw in some headphones and just go for a stroll around your neighborhood. You have a corner store or a grocery store close enough to you to walk instead of drive, even if it's a 10-15 minute walk, do that. This is kind of what I've started doing in terms of my own sense of meditation. I struggle with sitting down and meditating sometimes and just trying to focus. So I find when I walk, that's when I get to think and work through things that I'm going through. I'll pop my headphones in, I'll take Bentley, we'll walk around for 15, 20, 30 minutes, and it's such an added bonus that it keeps you active. Even if you don't have time to work out throughout the weeks, going on walks is a good workout as long as you're doing it consistently. It's such a simple habit to have and a simple habit to make, but it will change your life. And then my last and final habit to change your life is pick one day a week that you get your shit together. I honestly, this habit is something I've been doing for so long. Every single week, pick one day. It can be whatever day works for you, Mondays, Saturdays, Sundays, and just have that day to get your shit together because that will keep you on top of everything on a weekly basis. Booking yourself in for getting like waxes or taking care of like your nails and your hair and like, you know, washing your makeup brushes, cleaning your apartment, taking out the garbage, meal prepping, planning out your groceries, budgeting your weeks, planning out your weeks in your day planner. All of these things are things that I plan on Sundays. Sunday, I get my actual shit together. I take like a nice hot bath or a hot shower. I do a deep conditioner in my hair. I do a face mask. It keeps me on top of everything. It keeps me on top of my hygiene. It keeps me on top of keeping my surroundings clean. Not only that, it's just like such a nice way to end the week and start Monday so fresh. Getting tasks done that you've been procrastinating, like cleaning your closet or washing your dog. Just do those things. Plan one day every single week where you just get all of the stuff that you need to get done, done. So that is it for my six healthy, successful habits to change your life. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know down below if you guys are already doing any of these or if you plan on doing any of these, and if you guys have any tips that you think have changed your life for the better to make you happier and more successful, leave those down below too. I hope you guys enjoyed this bonus video. I love you guys to the moon and back, and I will see you guys all on Monday's video. Bye guys. I feel so close to you right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart upon my sleeve.